is always welcome to all of you. Most things to be questioned. Thank you for being here and joining us today. Thank you for that study. We started last week and we started to bend and see the presence. And we continue this week and we start to go to the church. This is a course of the Lord's Church. So, we have to do that. If you have to do that, we in all your ways to courage. gospel as well with us to meet us. Therefore, the world will be made in the Jews' eyes. And we've got to read this in the gospel. You're going to be. Oh, yes, we want it. We're going to be. You say, not one day, but all 2 days. And we'll 5 days, we'll 10 days, we need to express for our whole life. And there it comes out of your nostrils. And it comes loathsome to you because you have despised the poor and the hungry and have wept before him, saying, why did we ever come up out of Egypt? And Moses said to people, whom I am among, like 600,000 men on foot, yet you have said I would give them meat, that's just the meat. They may eat the whole monster. Swamps and hurricanes, smart for them to provide enough for them, and draw all the fish of the sea together for them to provide enough. And the Lord said to Moses, can't they wait for us to wait on their children? Now you can see whether what I say will happen to you. So Moses went out and told the people to go and gather the 70 men of the elders of the people, and they said, and the loud spoke of the spirit that was upon Moses and prayed the same upon the 70 elders. And it happened when the spirit rested upon them that they prophesied, although they never did so again. They clearly had remained in the temple. And then the one was heard of, and the other was healed of. And the spirit rested. Now they were among those listening. So he had not been taught to the tabernacle yet the gospel of his camp. And a young man named told Moses said, hey, let me try to prophesy in the camp. And Joshua, the son of Nun, Moses sister, one of his first men, and said, Moses, my Lord, forbid them, stop them. Moses said, are you jealous for my sake? Oh, that all the Lord's people were prophets, and that the Lord would put his spirit upon them. Now, women were not from the Lord. And so, Quayle, I love Mr. Quayle. I do. Especially with the biscuits and gravy. Yay! Got Quayle from the sea and left them fluttering with a kiss. About a day's journey to this side, about a day's journey from the other side. All around the kiss! And about 2 cubits above the surface from the ground. And in perspective, look at this eye. There's a bunch of them. They're everywhere. The wild meat was shared between the two. Oh, I'm sorry. And Peter, I'm reading the wrong verse. And Peter stayed up all that night. All that day and night, and let's say they gathered the quail. He who gathered least gathered 10 elders. And they spread them out. You might as well say, bushel back. And they spread them out for themselves, all around the camp. The wild meat was still in the camp. For it was true, the wrath of the Lord was the wrath of the Lord. And the Lord destroyed them. Called the name of the place, he brought the favor that they gave to people who had healed, healed, and prayed. And he brought the favor that people moved to Hazelot to the temple. My favor is that so capital. That's the kingdom of the Lord that he healed. They received God's written word. Israel was in the 3 days past that traveling. Comfortably closed to almost a foot. The life had been pretty good. Israel had been well. But now, after coming this place, 3 days stayed comfortably in pain, or away from the comfortable in pain.
it is intense and maybe it's just like, we're tired of this mess. We need to be limited. Now, this man is just curious. He's important. He's important. He's trying. He's important. He's just speaking. I mean, he's a being that we need to do. He's just taking that place. Yeah! And you could not be able to be like him. If what you get for the morning would be more than what you can do in death. And you couldn't keep it all night because it's strength that he has today. You can do it for that. But I do it all in death. Nobody would come to you. The focus is no longer on the front of the hand, but on the focus is on the private side. The focus is just on the private side. Not even the fact that it was just a joke. It did not matter if my God was the best or the last of it. The heaven and the earth matter. I'm not going to be the best of God. It was now the old song. The boring new thing. And they want to flesh the meat. That's my God. Even to death, Christian people can become so accustomed to the gifts of God, the blessings, the anointing, the spiritual, the salvation, the deserved for my sins, that we no longer exist. And that is the for God becomes the king. And when we find ourselves wanting something more, we can grow disbelieving and eventually. That's why there's so many crazy churches out there today. People will flock to these crazy churches that promise you everything from a good nickel cigar to a chicken in every pot. They promise to grow back limbs. They promise to raise the dead. They do everything else. They give you miracle water, free miracle water, if you only send them 45 bucks. That's the case. John TV, that's 3 o'clock in the morning, he does that. We will send you the three miracle waters if you will only invest in our ministries 40 times a day. It is going to be the same thing. And the miracle water is probably something they feel that the sun has tried to make. That's just a fact. I'm telling you the way it is that people will be able to do it. Why? God is coming to you. Everything is just we want something new, we want something exciting. I mean, if the God of the Bible were not exciting, something's wrong in your life. If the life, death, the resurrection God, the Lord Jesus, were not exciting, something is wrong in your life, and you become dissatisfied, you become distorted, and this contentment has set into your life, big down. The description of mammon is so positive in the text. No, the description of mammon is so positive in the text. And people have no heart to this that he read. Notice the crazy translation of Israel's strength and wants them to come to satisfy the past of Israel. They began to think about their past life in Egypt and how he was fulfilled. They remember the teaching. The truth, the meat. The leaf, the onions, the garlic in your salad, in the wonderful life you have in Egypt. Think about this. When did Ministries of Praise ever have that kind of stuff? They didn't. They did not. They just barely had enough to get by. Many Israelites starved to death. In the future, the prosperity is not enough for souls. When we think that when we become dissatisfied with God, our old lives have changed against the prosperity of the world. They have sick people like Tony already forgotten how bad it is to take them to the street. They no longer worry about scars or riches on their back. And Dallas coming to them from doing all the work they took in the sticks to go with it. Now they were renaissance the past because they were satisfied with God. Him, he says, my Bible says to miss multitude. The King James says he must say to rabble. Or some of the newer versions will say to rabble. One of the two, I forget which one. And I'll tell you what happened. Because in the rabble, the next smoke through the bomb started this discontentment. Now, who was this rabble? And I hate rabble. There we go. I knew I'd come because I was starting out. The rebel within the kingdom of Jesus is the kingdom of the Lord. Where do you say, I'm going to be like this? Oh! Who is the rebel? Well, these were non-Israelites. He left Egypt with Israel. More than likely, nobody can say this truth. I'm telling you, nobody can say this truth. But more than likely, they were probably rich Egyptians that went along to get away from Egypt, who had been devastated. You see, many Egyptians were afraid that God was going to destroy them all. I mean, think about it. Israel plundered all of Egypt's wealth on their way out. Not only did God take him from him, he got into Egypt, place of the camp, that took gold and silver and everything else with him, mules and donkeys and camels and oxen. Egypt gave him everything they had just to go away. And some of these rich people said, well, God's going to destroy the nation. He said, we better go where else. We're just going to take our money and rip it. You know about taking this kind of statue from Scripture. Had to have organized a special wedding. Notice that each family stood at the end of the tent at the same time and all got out loud together. And they must have known that some Moses would be moving his kingdom to the place of the presence of God. So they left the tent to do their work. Now, even Moses discovered that the people were focused on God. Even his focus on God. Even he began to become. Look at 11 here. Look at 11, right? 11. The Lord said to the Lord, why have you rejected me? And why have I not found favor in your sight that you have laid the burden of all these people off me? I didn't cause all these people to be born. Did I? Being glad that you should say to me, carry them in your bosom as a guardian carries the nursing child to the land that you swore to their fathers. Where am I to get meat to give all these people? For they weep all over me, saying, give us meat to eat. I'm not able to bear all these people alone because the burden is too heavy for me. If you treat me like this, just kill me here and there. Especially if I can hold you in the sun, do not let me see my face. Get the man on him now. Everybody else is laughing, it's contagious, and it falls on him. Just like being positive can be contagious, so can be discontented. Killing part of the rabble, only to stop the fire because Moses was praised. And what this was is an early warning to Israel about the nature of the contending spirit. We are not supposed to have the contending spirit. You may have some doubts, you may have some fear, you may even have some doubts, but we are not supposed to have the contending spirit. This fire obviously had not altered Israel's attitude too much. So God used Moses to do this. They sent even Moses to the wilderness of the desert to meet with the Israelites. We are so used to being measured, it's very hard to see the positive, even when it's not. Before Moses could get the focus back, Moses needs to get his focus back. And God comes up with a plan to help stop the spread of this fire. He will pour out his spirit on 70 other people. They will be the spiritual support what Moses needed. You see one of the troublesome things here? Nobody was praying for Moses. Nobody was holding up Moses' hands. Nobody was standing alongside Moses saying, "We trust you. We trust you. You're talking to God. We believe what God's telling you. We're on your side." Nobody is taking his side. God says, "I've got something to do. I'm going to walk in my spirit. You're going to be your spiritual backbone." That's exactly what they were. They became Moses' spiritual backbone. Moses needed a new focus on the team. Could only come from his spirit, will, respect, and insanity, the gratitude of the God. We struggle with this in terms of the spiritual people who have their eye on God. That's why I'm always telling you, if you surround yourself with godly people, don't run with the rabbit, don't run with those Christian people. If the prophet is complaining, even in church, get away from them. Get away from them. Find yourself somebody who believes in the power of the Spirit of God. Run with them. They are people who will lift you up. They are people who will embolden you, strengthen you, pray for you, and encourage you each and every day. God sent 70 other elders of Israel with his spirit to be a spiritual foundation to Moses. Unfortunately, negative people tend to find other negative people because they don't think they're right about them. Now, this one can be tough. God's question is faith. Moses tells Israel that God is going to grant their demands for me. Privately, he tells that God, how is this going to work? Moses is very aware that he cannot meet the needs of God's people. But the needs are well beyond his ability. God will provide spiritual food for Moses. Moses needs the spiritual. God provides spiritual resources. Together, spiritual people. Moses himself was struggling with the demands of their nation. They wanted to take the lead met by the step by their standards. And Moses is trying to show them the way of faith, which is the necessary foundation for the Holy Spirit's rebellion. Unfortunately, Israel shows the leader. Fleshly, earthly, flesh, fleshly divide over the spiritual one. Earthly youth, when our demands and prayers show a clear desire that is greater, that is greater for earthly things than it is for heavenly things. When we're praying more for a new batch boat than we are for God's Spirit to anoint our families, to save our families, to win our friends, and save their souls, something is wrong in our lives. Israel has a discontent for the division God has made available to them to use Christ. This particular generation never made it to the promise. The same generation that is fighting and complaining right now never made it to the promise. They rejected God's ways for their own human desires. And it repeatedly led them away from the spirit of grace God intended for them to do. God never came for the generation of Israel, for the generation of Israel to die in the grave, or for them to miss out on the promise of God, but for their pleasure with God's ways and the cravings for the ways of the world destroyed them. Each time they listened to the negative people, it's the prophecy of Israel. God builds up, and Satan, through the power of the world, is only God's jurisdiction. Israel chose to praise the faith and the life of the Spirit, and that's the best thing. When they had the heavenly bread, they grew tired of it. We must daily guard our hearts that we do not grow tired of our heavenly bread with fear. God's will to bear the life. There is a real danger to the spiritual things that we have to do. God's presence is the power of the world. If there is a complaining heart, it desires more and more flesh, and the And I love that part. I'm going to get into it myself. God does it. You know, the lady said, Daddy, I'm not going to be so weak. I'm going to be able to get it. You're going to get there. These water swimmers know that real contentment is spiritually missing. And it is available to anyone because it's not spent on real rest and spiritual life. Real contentment is based on the spirit of real God. Do not give in to discontentment. Surround yourself with spiritual, spirit-led people who trust in the provision of God and love them. And you will be continually blessed by God. Look to him as real as a place of contentment. Father, thank you for that. The blessings for the joy, for the hope, and the safety that we have. Grant us your favor, your grace, your glory. Let us refuse to give in to the discontentment of this world and of this world. We must not be content, but desire that the blessings of the kingdom and the bread of life, sustaining us, filling us, causing us to be sustained with the blessings of God. We love you tonight, and we pray to keep us from this discontentment. May it be consistent. We love you and be grateful for the blessings of God. Please, Father, send us thank you so very much. And again, ask for the light, ask for the spirit, and ask for the fire. We were so blessed this week, last week, that we were filling out the paper in the office, and the lady said, do you still pass through deep water for this minute? And said, well, my neighbor goes through that trip, and I had to start to explain that we're not a brick and mortar church, we're a conscious. Yeah, I know. And my neighbor never misses church. He just one time. So you can come too. You know, I'm going to turn on your phone, turn on your computer. We're right there. Go on to your baby's house. Praise the Lord. Somebody's listening to this letter. And the truth that we're trying to get to this. God bless you. We love you. Have a blessed week. Take a little bit of your mind and ease. Surround yourself with spiritual people and be consistent in the things of God. God loves you. Say the word. God bless you.